My name is Obuagodi Nakamaiko, and this is a short overview on strokes. Strokes are a result of blockage of blood flow to the brain. Now, any blockage of blood flow to the brain will cause a stroke. Strokes occur when there is an impediment to the blood flow of blood to the brain. Any situation that causes the blood that flows to the brain to be stopped, or the brain cells not having enough oxygen. Strokes technically are referred to as cerebrovascular accidents. First type of classification is ischemic stroke. And ischemic strokes occur when there is blockage of blood flow to the brain. This can be caused by a narrowing of the vasculature of the brain, or blockage by blood clot, or fatty cells in the vasculature. Now, ischemic strokes are the most common type of strokes. Ischemic strokes account for 80 to 85% of all strokes that occur worldwide. Hemorrhagic strokes. Hemorrhagic strokes occur when there is a situation of blood leakage from the vasculature of the brain into the brain, or blood leakage from the cells. Now, this blood leakage can be caused by a variety of factors, such as uncontrolled hypertension. There are three major ways that are indicated for worldwide currently. The major ways can be indicated by the first two letters of stroke, S, T, and R. The S stands for smile, the T stands for talk, and the R stands for raise hands. Raise both hands. One of the first things that you ask a patient that is suspected of having a stroke to do is to raise their hands. Raise their hands. You ask the patient to raise both arms. If the patient is unable to raise both arms above their head, then the stroke is suspected. Now, that is for R. For S, you ask the patient to smile. A patient having a stroke may not be able to complete a full smile. Now, if a patient is trying to smile, a part of the face might be drooping. That is a very clear symptom that a patient might be having a stroke. The third symptom is talk. S, T, and R. T. Now, T, talking. You ask the patient to repeat a very simple sentence, as simple as Obi is a boy or Obi is going to the market. Now, if the patient starts to slur their words or is unable to complete the speech as they are repeating this statement, it is possible that the patient is having a stroke. Now, the third thing to do is ask the patient to raise their hands above their head. And if a patient raises their hands above their head and they are not able to maintain it or bring one arm up, it is possible the patient is having a stroke. The major identifying symptoms of stroke are numbness and paralysis and inability to move one side of the body. The things to do when you notice a stroke are, notice that the patient may be having a stroke, first of all, ask the patient to smile. The patient is unable to smile or smiles and one part of the face is unable to smile or starts to droop, the patient is possibly having a stroke. Ask the patient to talk. Ask the patient to repeat a very simple sentence. The patient is unable to repeat this very simple sentence, it is possible that the patient is undergoing a stroke. However, in hemorrhagic stroke, use of anticoagulants is discouraged. Now, in differentiating the type of treatment to use for a stroke, it is necessary for proper scans and proper diagnosis to be made to determine the type of stroke that has occurred and what to do about it. Other treatments that can be used for stroke include surgery, as can be used for hemorrhagic stroke. The role of the pharmacist in managing stroke is in the identification of the symptoms of stroke and in proper referral of stroke patients to the stroke units of hospital. It is very necessary that stroke be treated as an emergency, which it is. Any person that encounters a stroke and is not sent to the hospital within the first 30 to 35 minutes, stands a very high risk of having permanent complications. The first thing to do and the thing to always do is refer the patient to the hospital. Thank you very much.